Today on Diesel U, we're going to talk about how a turbocharger works. And the reason why we wanted to do this video is because we have this very nice cutaway turbocharger unit that was given to us by Industrial Injection. It's been one of the talking pieces on our table at shows, and it's also a very good teaching tool. So we're going to get into it with you now. We're going to use some good redneck terminology like we always like to do when we're explaining how a turbocharger works. So let's talk about the major components of a turbocharger first. And we're going to start with the front side. On the front side here, you have your compressor side of the turbocharger. On the back side, you have your turbine side of the turbocharger or the turbine housing. The center section that contains all the goodness, this is your CHRA or your center housing rotating assembly. Now, you also have another major component of this turbocharger in particular is your wastegate. So let's talk about each of these components independently, and let's just talk about how a turbo works. So your exhaust gases coming from your engine, from your exhaust manifold more specifically, enter the turbocharger through the turbo foot, or you hear us talking about T3, T4, T6, loose terms, I call it a foot, we all call it a foot really here. So it attaches to the exhaust manifold at this port. Exhaust gases enter here. They enter here, they go through the turbine housing, they enter in the turbine housing, and thereby they drive the turbo wheel. The turbo wheel converts this into kinetic energy, converts in kinetic energy. So you have a rotating assembly here that has the turbine wheel on it and also the compressor wheel on it. So the exhaust gases from the engine, the more exhaust gases that are coming at a greater speed, the higher the revolution of the engine, the faster that the turbine wheel is actually spinning. Now there are different configurations in turbine housings as well. Smaller turbine housings are able to divert the air faster. Larger turbine housings are able to slow down the turbine wheel and the rotating assembly as a whole, and they're also able to get more exhaust gases off of the turbine wheel. All right, now let's talk about the compressor side. The compressor side is turning, obviously, by, again, the shaft that connects the turbine wheel and the compressor wheel. The compressor wheel is bringing in the ambient air, and it is compressing it, going through the compressor housing, and compressing it and sending it out to the intercooler, or in some instances, it's going to be going directly into the engine on some of the non-intercooled vehicles. Now your center housing, your CHRA or center housing rotating assembly, your oil will enter into this assembly. It is going through this passage, and it has passages cut in it going to, if it is a journal bearing style turbo, goes into the soaks the journal bearing and then goes right straight out the oil drain too. Now some of the turbos are also water cooled as well. They'll have a combination of oil and water going into them that helps to keep the turbocharger nice and cool. Now let's talk about this turbocharger in particular because it contains a wastegate. A wastegate is a tool that is used to divert turbine gases away from the turbine, thereby slowing down the turbo and making it a more efficient unit. Let's talk about that in just a minute. Wastegates are preset to X amount of PSI. Once the compressor is producing X amount of PSI, that opens the wastegate. In this application, some wastegates are vacuum control, some of them may be electronically controlled, so it's getting a message from the ECU to open it, but in this case, it is mechanically controlled. The wastegate thereby opens. That diverts the gases off the turbine wheel, and it goes, those gases at that time go straight out the exhaust housing side, so you can regulate the turbine speed to keep the turbocharger from over speeding, thereby making a more efficient assembly because you're wanting your drive pressures as close as they possibly can be. So that's just a really good overview of turbochargers. There's lots and lots of information out there on the internet on how turbochargers work. Some really great stuff with a lot more technical verbiage in it than I've used here. But I just wanted to give a good rough breakdown of how a turbocharger works for you. So if you have a question on this or any of our other videos, please give us a call. Thank you.